Hey guys, this is your daily dose of movies. Today I'm talking about sci-fi adventure movie, Ender's Game, with a budget of $110 million, and rating of 6.6 by IMDb. Aliens known as the Formics assaulted Earth 50 years ago, killing millions. Only because of the sacrifice of the finest commander, Mazer Rackham, who crashed his F-35 Lightning II into a Formic queen ship at the seeming cost of his life, the Earth escaped ultimate extinction. The Earth is waiting for the Formics to launch a fresh onslaught. So, in the near future, mankind is prepared to launch an assault on the Formics' homeworld before they return to Earth. The International Fleet trains talented youngsters for 50 years to become commanders of a new fleet for this counterattack. Every youngster wears a monitor on their neck so that they may be studied. Cadet Andrew Ender Wigan, 12, is one of these youngsters, and his skill in simulated space warfare catches the attention of Colonel Hiram Graff and Major Gwen Anderson. Colonel Graff and Major Anderson are studying Ender's conversation tactics after Ender defeats Stilson in the game, so they decide to observe how Ender handles rejection and order the removal of his monitor, indicating the end of the cadet program. Ender is later accosted by Stilson, a bully student he fought in the combat sim, but Ender fights back and seriously injures him. Ender has returned home and expresses his anguish to his older sister Valentine, but they clash again and are bullied by his older brother Peter. While Ender and his family are having dinner, it is discovered that every family can only have two children, but Ender is the third and claims that he should not have been born, hence the parents required permission for Ender to be born. Ender's father comforts him by saying that it's a difficult program, and that when he first arrived to this country, there was less competition, but he still didn't make it. When Graff arrived at their house that evening, Colonel Graff and Major Anderson began to wonder why Ender continued kicking Stilson after he had previously fought him. Ender said that knocking him down was the first fight, but he wanted to win all next ones too. Graff then gave Ender a spot in their program since what he did was tactical, and Graff admits that he was being tested and is still a member of the program. Graff transports Ender to Battle School, an orbiting space station in Earth's orbit, where he is placed among other cadets his age, but regards him as exceptional, isolating him from the rest. Sergeant James Dapp assures cadets on the first evening they meet him that he would answer any legitimate questions with a clear response, but if they need a shoulder to cry on, they must use their pillow. Cadets instantly began to giggle, but stopped as fast as they began. Sergeant James also explained, first if they are discovered at other gender showers, he will personally neuter them. Discipline takes precedence above everything else at this point. Among other studies, the cadets are divided into squads and participate in training activities in a zero-gravity battle room. Ender swiftly adapts to the activities, creating new techniques that older children haven't seen before. Later, Ender participates in a computerized mind game, created in a fantasy world designed to provide the player with tough decisions, but he is unable to win the game at this time. Graff and Major Anderson are monitoring how he makes decisions. Actually, they can't play these games, but Anderson granted permission to open the game for analysis of Ender's mind. Graff sends Ender to the Salamander Army, which is headed by Commander Bonzo, a short, spiteful, but formidable squad commander. Ender is banned from practicing with the rest of the group since Bonzo believes he is ineffective due to his height. Petra, another cadet, takes Ender and trains him individually. Despite the fact that Bonzo is aware of this, he does not take any action against Petra. In one round, Bonzo tells Ender to wait behind while the rest of the Salamander army confronts another squad. Nevertheless, when Ender notices Petra in peril, he rushes to her aid and helps the Salamander army in winning. Bonzo is embarrassed by the other students after the competition and threatens Ender if he embarrasses him again. Later, Ender continues computerized mind game in which he devises an out-of-the-box solution to a seemingly intractable issue. In the game, he meets a Formic, followed by a simulated vision of Valentine exploring the remains of a castle. Inside, he discovers another picture of Valentine, but as he approaches, it transforms into an image of Peter before the game is over. Graff elevates Ender to his own squad, which is made up of cadets who have earned Ender's trust, It's a dragon army that has never won a fight. They are the same children who were with Ender at the start, but now he's a commander. They are forced to fight in more severe battles. Ender devises an innovative tactic of sacrificing part of his team to accomplish a goal in one match against two other teams, including Bonzo's squad, Dazzling Graf. After the contest, Bonzo confronts Ender in the restroom, but Ender fights back and Bonzo collapses during the battle, gravely hurt, so Ender avoids future fights again. Ender is horrified over this, and he wants to see how Bonzo is healing and talk with his sister Valentine. If he isn't returned home soon, he plans to abandon battle school. Graf agrees, but wants Valentine to talk to Ender and persuade him to stay since Graf sees something in him and Ender is essential to them. Ender is returned home for a little period of time and is able to communicate with Valentine. Graf then transports Ender to humanity's advance outpost on a former Formic planet close to their homeworld. Ender encounters a mysterious guy who informs him that he is a teacher, but also an opponent, since the greatest experience may be earned by battling an enemy. It turns out that he is Rackham, who reveals how he discovered the Formic's shared mind nature and used it to prevent the invasion 50 years ago. Ender discovers that his old squadmates have arrived to assist him in computerized simulations of massive fleet battle. Rackham places particular focus on the fleet's molecular detachment, MD, device, which is capable of disintegrating matter. Ender's training is difficult, and Anderson is concerned that they are pushing Ender too quickly, but Graf points out that they have run out of time to replace Ender. Several fleet commanders are watching Ender's last test. Ender's fleet is greatly outnumbered when the simulation begins, and he finds himself above the Formic homeworld. Ender notices that the Formics are not battling, but rather waiting for something to happen. However, in order to pass the exam, they must fight them. Remembering that this is only a realistic simulation, he orders the majority of his fleet to sacrifice themselves in order to safeguard the MD long enough to fire a weapon on the homeworld. They must clear the way with fire so that Petra can see and fire MD on the surface of the Formic's planet. The ensuing chain reaction fires over the planet's surface, destroying the entire population. The film's major storyline surprise has arrived. Ender assumes the test is completed when the simulation finishes, but the commanders reactivate the video displays, revealing that the destruction of the Formic homeworld was genuine and Ender was in charge of the actual fleet this time. Ender is enraged, despite Graf's guarantee that he would be remembered as a hero, since he feels responsible for the devastation and that everyone will remember him as a murderer. As Ender fights with his emotions, he notices one of the Formic constructions nearby that looks similar to the damaged castle from the game and sprints out towards it, assuming they were attempting to communicate with him. He follows the game's instructions and comes upon a dying Formic queen. Ender's part in his race's annihilation is acknowledged by the queen, but he just desired long-term peace and is forgiven. Ender is subsequently given a queen egg that the queen had been guarding. Ender is promoted to admiral after the conflict, given a tiny ship, and left to his own ways. He informs Valentine in a letter that he is leaving for outer space, intending to establish a new Formic colony with the queen egg. Hope you enjoyed this dose of movies. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See ya.